Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Build Heroine's Fortress. I know this episode is a little bit late, but that's because I tried some new things of how to record, and you will probably notice it in a second. So, last time we hit the dungeons that we made, and of course, one thing that our castle or fortress really needs is a roof or something on top. And that is something we're going to do today. But since it's some kind of weird shaped castle, I didn't really know what to do. So I just brought one of those up higher and made this entire area flat, as you can probably see from now on. And this is the new way of recording for me, at least. I hope that this will keep working. In the beginning I had some problems with it. It works fine now. I think there's one problem that you can see visible in the video, but not for long. And as you can see also, the camera angle isn't like completely perfect or whatever. Just let you know, this is the first time I do it this way, so it can be that some things aren't good or perfect. Hopefully in next episodes it will be better. But okay, what I did here was I took out one layer and just went around the whole structure. You can see me going out of the screen or going away just randomly. That's my laptop. I'm building on my laptop, and sometimes the Minecraft on my laptop can be a real dick, I tell you. It's not funny anymore. If I just press, for example, if I press A, I release A, and in the game it hasn't released yet, so it keeps moving away. It's really annoying. And of course, since my laptop isn't made for gaming, but more for running servers and stuff like that, it has a really terrible graphic card, and I can barely play Minecraft, seriously. This is one of the things that you can see. Sometimes I accidentally hit my mouse of my computer itself, but I think after a while I put the mouse away. That should be somewhere around here. So, okay, this is one of the towers that I'm going to build up with. Or actually, I'm going to build up. As you can see, my first attempts were really slow, even when it is the 400% time speed, so it took me like four times this, blah, blah, blah. I don't know. And it seems spinning out again. So this really took a long time, so eventually, a commentary, but something that you only do in survival normally. It's just jump, place, block, jump, place, block, jump, place, block, so just press spacebar, press right mouse button, and go up. It's actually it. And something else that you might have noticed already is that the game looks a little bit different. That's because I am using the shaders mod. So if you like it, tell me. Also the new way of recording. If you like it, tell me. If you don't, I will probably go back. Well, if more people like it, then more people that won't like it, if you know what I mean. I think you know. Something else that I want actually in this this way of filming is that the camera can move around the structure a little bit. I know there's a mod for it. I don't know how it's called, so if somebody can tell me how it's called, I can download it, I can install it, and I probably will get better shots at this. And also the intro and outro shots can be probably better, so I don't have to control by hand and I can do it with the computer, and I think it's going to be a lot more smoother than I do it now. And you can see that I did the one row of blocks at a time. But you can also do like, I don't know, three high blocks and then going around and then up every time. You can do it if you want, but I like this one in this part because I already had the height. So it was, maybe this is going to be better or smoother. So now it was time for the roof of the tower. I did something similar to the thing I did with the outer towers. I want to go like really high, at least a little bit high. So what I did was again a block of nether brick and above there a nether brick stairs. And I repeated that going in every time I had a nether brick stair. This is one of those moments as you see that like I might have been a little bit too far away from the object that's where you're filming. So next time I will try to get closer and switch things like this. I'd hit my mouse again somehow, even when it was on my desk. Really weird actually. One real good thing about this way of filming is that I can do bigger things in every episode. Because normally if I build and I do it like first person, I can only double the speed because otherwise the screen will just pass out. But if I do it now with a steady screen and just going around, I can do it. I can wrap the speed really up and it's going to be way way faster. So for me it's a lot easier and I can do way more things in one episode. Or at least bigger things. Otherwise I probably had half episode only doing this, placing blocks of, I don't know, it's called wood. As you can see, I took the outer parts and eventually I went in and did a square going around every time. And something else was that I probably must have said before this happened. I didn't want the nether brick to take floor here. Because everything's going to be the same and I didn't want it in this part. So I choose for normal wood. Because I like it. I like wood. Somehow. It's really medieval stuff, I think. And it looks nice. So, what we had now was one huge flat area and I wanted to have some kind of guard railings post, I don't know. And for that I used the normal stairs or the brick stairs and I went around the whole outer structure or the border of the structure. And I know some people told me that there is no day-night circle in the nether. I noticed while I was recording it that there actually is a day-night circle. But you just only can't see it because normally there's a roof. As you can probably see in the video that sometimes it's darker and sometimes it's lighter. Or more light. So that's how. So something else I wanted a little bit more this or... details into the building. So this is something that I do in a lot of structures. Every time if I go out, I do something like this. I use one block, a normal block of the material I used and the stair block that I used. And I go around the whole structure, at least the whole, and I place them at least below the part that got out. Okay, now I wanted, because I had time left, and I was like, I got time left because normally I will be now have a 20 minutes episode, now have a 10 minute episode, or 15. So I got time left, I decided to put some detail into the tower that I made. So I started with creating rings around the whole tower. It's 4 blocks between every ring, and it fitted perfectly into it. At least it fitted perfect in the tower. So now I've got the rings, and I was like, this isn't enough. I want something more. And I decided to put some windows into it. Actually, I had a clear design that I immediately wanted to choose. You can't really see it, but you can see it in the outro video. It is just 3 brick stairs on top. Go a fence post going side of them, and in between them, 2 windows. And I repeated this pattern around the whole structure, or at least the whole fingeringy tower. As you can see something here, this is the design that I used. And somehow this is a little bit shocky, but it can be that it is in my video editing program. If it's not shocking, never mind me. And you can see me here that I am repeating the pattern that I used on the first start. I'm doing it all around the whole tower. What I did, the strategy that I used to building this was actually just first make those brick stairs, then the fence post, then the windows. Something that I really missed in this build is actually world edit, since I upgraded to 1.2.5 and I didn't have any time to put in world edit, so I just started recording without it, and that's can be really annoying. But I actually went back to the vanilla building and I kind of liked it. World edit is a nice tool to help you, but vanilla building is also really nice. So this is the end result of the whole structure. You can see the tower, the roof that we made, and there's a flat roof so you can go on top of it and defend the whole fortress from there. Or fly away on dragons if you want to. I know that the tower isn't really big or huge, but I don't really mind because I think it's just because it's different. It looks really nice somehow. It looks really weird, but at the same moment really good somehow, if you know what I mean. Okay, I just can't explain it. But yeah, okay, so well, that was Let's Build Bilbo's Fortress episode, or yes, part 5, episode 5. And well, if you enjoyed it, like, comment, subscribe, do whatever you want. And I will see you next time. I've been Duncan.